In this chapter, that is testing of hypothesis, we'll be discussing about interval estimation and testing of hypothesis. Now, before starting with this, let's discuss where do we use this. Now, basically, given any population, what we'll do is we just take sample, a smaller sample, and then generalize the result for the population. But whenever we are generalizing the result for population, we actually don't know to what extent it is correct, right? So, in such cases, we just have to look for the statistical inference. It is another branch of statistics wherein we just check to what extent the generalized result is correct, okay? So here we have two branches. One is theory of estimation and another is testing of hypothesis. Now, under theory of estimation, we have again two types, point estimation and interval estimation. But in our syllabus, we just have to discuss this interval estimation, okay? But what is point estimation? So, in point estimation, a single value of statistics is used to estimate the population parameter. Right? So, only a single value is used in case of point estimation. So what happens is, no matter what best value you are taking, it is not enough. The value, whatever we are going to get, is not going to be satisfactory value. That is the reason we go for interval estimation. Okay. So in interval estimation, what we are doing is we are looking for the value, okay, under the or in that particular interval. Suppose we are looking for this value theta, so we are going to look for the value in this in certain interval. So suppose these are c1 and c2, we have constants. So what theta, this value will lie in this particular interval, and this interval is called as a confidence interval, and this alpha is called as a level of significance. To what extent it is significant, the value whatever we are finding, okay, to what extent that value is going to be significant. Confidence coefficient, okay, that is given by 1 minus alpha. Now, what is confidence coefficient? Now, whatever parameters we'll be finding out, okay, whatever parameters we'll be calculating, to what extent we are confident about those particular parameters. Now, this confidence coefficient or level of, it is also called as the level of confidence. It can basically, in theoretical part, it can be either taken as 95% or it can be taken as 99%. So basically take either 95% or 99%. So if it is 95%, we write it as 0.95 and 99 then 0.99. Now, if your level of confidence is 95% or 0.95, now this alpha, that is significance, okay, or it is also called as the level of significance, it will be 0.05, or we can say it is a 5% level of significance. And if it is 99%, your level of significance will be 0.01, or we can say 1% of level of significance. So if 1% of level of significance, then confidence will be 99%, that is 0.99, and if 5% of level of significance, confidence will be 95%, that is 0.95. So basically we'll be only using either 95% or 99% for calculating the values of parameters. Interval estimation for large sample. Now, for large sample, the distributions, okay, of the standardized variate, this Z, corresponding to the statistical value T, right, is asymptotically normal. Okay, so this standardized value is asymptotically normal whenever this N will go towards infinity. N will tending and is tending towards infinity, and this is given by the central limit theorem. What is central limit theorem? So here we have central limit theorem. It says that if x1 till xn are independent random variables following any distribution, okay, then under certain very general condition, their sum is asymptotically normally distributed. That is, summation of x follows normal distribution as n tending towards infinity. So by this central limit theorem, what we can say is this standard normal variate or standardized variate is asymptotically normal as n is tending towards infinity. Now in this case, this is mean of all the values, and this is standard error. Now what is standard error? Standard error is nothing but standard deviation of the sampling distribution.